Naya Hallenquist, welcome, Naya.
Hey, Clint. So I'm Janaya. I'm a senior informatics major here at the state, and today I'm going to be talking to you guys about childhood injury. And the main character is me. Okay, so when I was younger, y'all, I was clumsy and always getting into stuff, and I had a lot of fractures, and you know, the doctors was like, maybe just need some more calcium or something. I don't know. Anyway, so when I was in like kindergarten, preschool, I don't know, something said slide down the slide with everybody else, so I'm sliding. And then something said go backwards. And I said, okay. So I went down the slide backwards. And nothing said get up so everybody else could go. So y'all, somebody came and ran over my arm with a tricycle. It broke. So, you know, they said, take Janaya to the doctor. Don't to the doctor, file cast. All right, so then, third grade, I was at my grandmother's house, and none of my cousins was there, so I was bored. So something said, stand up on that heater over there. I said, okay. So I stood up on a little electric heater, y'all, and it said, hold my balance. And I'm like, okay. So then my grandmother called me. I got real scared, so I fell. And I got my arm stuck between, like, the TV and the entertainment center. So I snatched it out, broke it. So the next injury was actually, I was older. I was in, like, middle school. And I was in a park, and I didn't want to walk around. So something said, jump over the pond. I fell in the pond and broke my arm again.
The same one?
Yeah, no, this, well, my right one and my left one, broken both in the same place. So, yeah, so that happened. So anyway, going to my high school, the summer before, I got my cast taken off, and I went to my new high school to see, get my schedule and everything, and I wanted to play volleyball. So I told my dad, I said, yo, let me play volleyball. And he was like, so you can dive on the floor and break your arm again? I said, first of all, that's not how it happened. So, he didn't let me play, and I was highly upset. So, I found this chart, not at the time, but now. I found this chart, and I said, how many people get hurt playing volleyball? Not a whole lot. So, compared to football and basketball and soccer and baseball, not a lot of people get hurt playing volleyball. That was my argument. Anyway, so he didn't let me play. So, I was upset a lot. I was very upset. So I decided to branch out into other things. One of my high school guidance counselors put me in weightlifting, and I was like, what? So anyway, I did the weightlifting thing. Turns out I was real strong, and the coach was like, yo, you should do track. And I said, what? So anyway, I tried out for the track team, doing like the throwing stuff, shot put, and things. So I did that, and I was real good at it. And then I said, I'm gonna do volleyball, I'm gonna do this. So anyway, this chart just basically shows you how many kids get injured by the top, the leading causes of injury, which is falls struck by an object or person, overexertion, and a bite or sting by like a dog or something like that. And I fell into the fall category a lot, and the struck by person or object category a lot. So my takeaway message for you guys today is, just if you have kids or if you have nieces or nephews, you know, make sure they don't do dumb stuff like me and hurt themselves, or make sure they wear helmets, and encourage them to play sports, but don't get hurt.
Is that true, Grant?